Materials used in this video are available from Jameco Electronics. Did you know that what we see as red light is actually a wave of electromagnetic energy oscillating at a frequency of around 450 terahertz? Did I just blow your mind a little bit there? I'll give you a moment. It's true. In fact, all light consists of electromagnetic waves. But when those waves oscillate at a frequency lower than 400 terahertz or so, the human eye can no longer see them. But that doesn't mean we can't still put them to good use. In fact, there's a whole range of frequencies just below visible light that we use often in electronics. And we call that range infrared light. Yeah, but it's infrared. It's not red. We can't see it, so it's not red. So just kill that. Cool. We can easily generate our own infrared light using infrared LEDs. Infrared LEDs, also known as IR emitters, often use blue, gray, or even black lenses to limit their output. The image sensors on most digital cameras will respond to infrared light, and this can be handy when you want to check to make sure an IR LED is working. Infrared light can be detected using an IR phototransistor. These look really similar to LEDs, but they work in almost the opposite way. When infrared light strikes the chip inside the lens, electricity is allowed to flow from one lead to the other. When used together, IR emitters and detectors can pull off some pretty interesting tricks. For example, this simple IR light barrier kit consists of a transmitter with IR LEDs and a receiver with an IR phototransistor. When light sent from the transmitter is blocked, the receiver responds by sounding a piezo buzzer. This basic object detector functionality has a long list of applications, from factory assembly lines to home security systems. And it might just be the thing I need to keep my cat from jumping up on the kitchen table. This passive sensor doesn't generate any infrared on its own. Instead, it responds to abrupt changes in the amount of infrared light around it. When first powered on, it calibrates itself to the amount of IR it currently sees. When that amount changes, it sends an electrical signal out from one of its terminal pins. Connecting one of these to a microcontroller board is an easy way to add motion sensing capabilities to a project.
But you probably best know infrared technology for its use in controlling devices wirelessly.
Pressing a button on a remote control causes an infrared LED to blink in a specific sequence. An IR sensor on a TV or other appliance receives this sequence and passes it to an internal chip which performs an appropriate action, like, say, changing a channel.
Thus allowing us to never leave the couch. Suffice it to say, we can do a lot with the light we can't see. And really, that's just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, I didn't even mention ultraviolet light. But we'll get to that another time.
Build your own infrared security beam with the IR light barrier kit, available at jameco.com. Thank you. Thank you.